To all those people watching, I'd like to remind everyone that this video is not made for kids. It's for older fans and adults. Enjoy the video!
Several hours passed, but everyone was still heartbroken by the incident with Sir Tom Hatt committing assault to Mr. Berkshire. A meeting was held at Sir Tom Hatt's mansion by the governor of Sodor later that evening.
Thank you all for coming. Now, according to the police department, Sir Tom Hatt has been sentenced to court. And according to the mayor, all steam-powered locomotives are grounded from service. Now then, at this time, Samantha Hatt, Richard's wife, will be your controller for the time being.
Thank you all.
Now,
as heartbroken as I am, I've decided to move on and run this railway like how my husband would have wanted. Hopefully, I can do a great job and make all proud. Glad you want to make Sodor a better place, which makes it a true honor having you here. Anyways, I don't think there's anything else to discuss, so you may all be dismissed.
At Tim McShed's, the engines and Samantha had an indignation meeting about the incident.
All right, everyone. I've come up with a solution of how we can keep ourselves more safe.
So, what's the plan?
Yeah, me and my best friends want to know.
Well, what the DOD people want is for modern diesels to take over your railway. So, here's my brainwave. Why not escape Sodor so we cannot be destroyed by Jacob and his crew? I've already contacted a workshop in Wales where they have reserved spots for you all.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
Wouldn't they just follow us to the workshop?
Oh, come on, guys. We'll probably have extra supervision.
Thomas is right. The defenders of diesels don't like to read the articles from the NWR news company. But if they do find out, then we'll put a special camera that will tell us if they followed us that will be connected to my phone.
Oh, alrighty then.
So everything was arranged. Ships started picking up the narrow and miniature engines along with the Coley Fell residents, while other engines were digging out coal from the mines in order to have a huge supply for their escape.
Oh, hey there, sir.
How's it going?
We're alright, I guess.
Guys, look! A coal pile!
Look at all that, people!
You know, since we don't have any work soon, I can finally find a place where I can be all
Alone.
Alright, don't you dare copy me or else!
After his mining duties, Duke dropped off the workmen. He also left his coach at the transfer yards where he spent some time alone.
Guess I'm about to feel Smudger's pain.
Just then, he heard a whistle. It was Victor. He was inspecting the Scarloy Railway before lockdown.
Wait a minute, my friend. Who's Smudger?
Well, back when I worked on the Mid-Solar Railway, there was an engine named Smudger. He was constantly locked into his cage. Other engines kept having to pick him up and take him back to the sheds.
And then what happened, my friend?
Well, the manager decided that he had enough. And made him useful at last by leaving him in the back of our sheds as a generator that they had turned him into.
Oh my goodness, that sounds horrible. Hopefully this lockdown isn't worse. The railway is going to be closed until the defenders of diesels get arrested.
Yeah, I hope so too.
But meanwhile for the engines, they were getting ready for their great escape.
Well, we're off.
Alright, let's head out.
All the engines said their goodbyes before heading off, but afterwards, the entire Northwestern Railway was officially closed and became completely silent. Must our prayers go out
to the engines of the NWR.